Here are just a few tips for working on the middle school all-state bassoon solos. First, I would start with learning the rhythm really well. There might be some rhythms in here that you have not seen a whole lot, especially the triplet towards the end. Probably you've been subdividing eighth notes, dee da 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 dee dee dee. But once you get to the half note coming before the triplet, you want to switch to a subdivision of triplets, yet da 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 dee da dum bum bee da, so that you have the triplet in your brain when you are approaching it. So learn the rhythm really well. Don't go faster than you can go, and it might help to learn it in small chunks. So learning 2 measures at a time or 4 measures at a time. There are also a lot of rests in this, and the music goes over the rests. So the phrase isn't one single eighth note and then a rest and then another single eighth note. Those aren't individual phrases. The phrase actually includes all of the notes and all the rests. So one way to keep it from feeling like individual notes and really vertical is to keep your air support ready even when there's rests. So for example, in the third line at measure 10, you have 2 staccato eighth notes. So as I play those eighth notes, I engage my air support muscles and I don't let it up in between the notes. Ta, 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 dee, da. Instead of puff, 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 which is actually more work. And you run the risk of not having your air engaged on time for any one note. Another thing to think about is the dynamics in this piece range from piano to mezzo forte. And then you have one forte towards the end. So it might help you to put numbers to those. Like if piano is 1, and then mezzo piano is 2, mezzo forte is 3, and then forte is 4. So that can help you gauge where you're going in your dynamics. And always practice with a musical intention. So whether it's about, you know, a beautiful fall day and the leaves falling to the ground, or if it's about your cat running around or something, have an idea of a story or an idea for the piece so that you're playing with a sense of music to it and you're not just playing it as if it was, you know, something you have to do, but really that's something you enjoy to do, and then it will be enjoyable for you and more enjoyable for whoever's listening to it. Good luck.